This is digital time division multiplexing and demand multiplexing trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40511. Here you can see on the panel different block diagram are shown. These are different terminals for the connections. This block is for 8-bit data generator. And the circuit diagram around the 7490 IC. These are the data output terminals D0 to D7. D6 and D7 is connected to ground. So this is low signal. D4 and D5. Directly connected to plus 5 volt supply, plus 5 volt internally supply. So this is high signal. D0, D1, D2 and D3 are clock outputs. So you can use these data outputs as a input terminal of a 8:1 multiplexer. This is multiplexer block. And circuit is made around 74151 IC. This is your 74151 IC. These are the data inputs. And this is the output of this block. Multiplexer output. This block is 1:8 demultiplexer. This is 74138 IC. And these are the data outputs. Multiplexer output is to be connected to multiplexer input, and the output of this demultiplexer section is available on all these terminals. Output Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 and so on, Y7. This section is clock and address generator. This is 555 IC which generates clock output, and clock output is available between these two terminals. And this is address generator IC 74163, and address signal is available at A0, A1 and A2 terminal. So these terminals are internally connected to A0, A1, A2 pin of 74138, and also connected to A0, A1, A2 pin of IC 74151. So all the address line are internally connected to the all required sections. Let us start with the experiment. To study digital time division, multiplexing and demultiplexing, switch on the experimental kit. Observe the bit A2 of the address generator to one channel of dual trace CRO. This is your dual trace CRO. And trigger the CRO with respect to the same channel. This is your A2 terminal. See your ground terminal. Connect the CRO between ground terminal and A2 terminal. This is A2. Observe the output of 8 to 1 line multiplexer on the second channel of CRO. This is second channel of CRO. 8 to 1 line multiplexer output. This is 8 to 1 line multiplexer output. Connect the second channel of CRO between these two terminals. Apply a high signal to the 8 multiplexing input one by one and observe the multiplexer output and see how the total time is divided by each channel with respect to the address generator. This is high signal D4 or D5. You can connect the D4 or D5. So start from X0. This is your A2 and this is output for X0 input. Now high signal is connected to X1 and this is the multiplexer output. This output is for X2 input. Now high signal is connected to X3. This is for X4. This is for X5. This is for X6. And last, high signal is connected to X7. And this is the waveform. This is A2 output. This is multiplexer output for high input at D0. This is for D1. This is for D2. And this is for D7. So you can observe the output of multiplexer by applying the high signal one by one from X0 to X7. Now connect 8-to-1 line multiplexer to the 1-to-8 line demultiplexer. Remove the CRO and connect these terminals to multiplexer input terminal. So 8-to-1 multiplexer is connected to 1-to-8 demultiplexer. Give any data available from the data generator to any multiplexer input and check the output corresponding data outputs. These are the data outputs of 8-bit data generator and these terminals are the data inputs of 8-to-1 multiplexer. So give any data, suppose X0 connected to D1, this is D1, and check the output, corresponding data output. Connect the second channel CRO to ground. All ground terminal are common. You can connect this CRO lead, ground lead to this ground or this ground. Anywhere you can connect the ground terminal of second channel CRO. Now your input is connected to, your data is connected to X0 terminal. So observe the data at Y0 terminal of 1-to-8 demultiplexer. So this is the Y0 output for X0 input. Now connect the D2 to X1. Now we have connected the D2 signal to X1 input of 8-to-1 multiplexer. Because we have connected data to X1 input, we have to observe this output at Y1 terminal. So this is the output of Y1 terminal. You can connect the different data to the different inputs and observe the outputs at corresponding demultiplexer output and compare the multiplexing inputs and corresponding demultiplexed output which are inverted. So you can study the different multiplexing and demultiplexing process with the help of this trainer. Trainer is digital time division multiplexing and demultiplexing. Order code of this trainer is 40511. Thank you.